For me, pain is such an interesting research area because even in health, we still don't understand all the mechanisms that drive pain.
Hey, hi, how are we doing?
Good,
I'm Joe,
you.
And I'm going to be taking you through all the sort of tests that we got for you today. So first stuff we'll be rolling with is we'll be starting with the cuff stuff and then moving on to some of the more sensory stuff that we have down here.
So the aim of the study is to understand why such a high proportion of individuals with Parkinson's are living with persistent pain. Because of the fact that pain is driven by a huge emotional context, each individual perceives their pain in a completely unique manner. It's estimated that up to 60% of individuals with Parkinson's have a lived experience of chronic pain. This pain can take on many different forms, and so understanding why they are experiencing that pain is crucial in order that we can optimise the pain relief that they're prescribed in the clinic. When we talk about persistent pain, we're talking about a pain that lasts for longer than 3 months. So we might have dreadful toothache for a few weeks and it dominates our every waking thought. We can't eat, we can't sleep. Imagine experiencing that for 12 weeks or longer. It has a major impact on the quality of life. And with this kind of research, we can start to understand how we can tackle the problem of pain in the clinic.
This study is incredibly important for the Parkinson's community. It's incredibly heartening to find a team of people who are so passionate about investigating this problem. So pain is a small part of the symptoms that I experience as part of my Parkinson's. My mother has Parkinson's disease also, and she does experience deep central pain, and it is debilitating. It does impact on her quality of life.
Within pain research, our aim is to understand better how we can group individuals and therefore treat their pain more quickly.
I've loved having the opportunity to talk to Kirsty and the team because their passion is definitely there. To know that there are people out there that are trying to make a difference to us gives us hope. Research for Parkinson's is essential in better understanding the disease and improving the quality of life for people living with Parkinson's. It's important to me because if people with Parkinson's don't take part in the research, there is no research. It's me doing my bit and maybe trying to encourage others to do the same. Also, amazingly grateful for the fact that there's funding to support the project.
For us as researchers, to receive this money means that we can carry out the very work that we know will make an enormous difference to those individuals who live with Parkinson's. Without that funding, this work would never happen. To receive funding from the community who believe in this kind of work is obviously a huge honour, and it validates the work we're doing, and it also galvanises us towards the end goal, which is to improve the quality of life of those with Parkinson's.